Welcome back, amigos, to another After Effects tutorial. I recently worked on an ESPN feature where I implemented a sticker effect for the lower thirds, and I thought it would also look pretty cool for sports. So in this tutorial, I'll show you the process of creating this sticker effect step by step. And remember that life is truly a gift. Make it count. Let's create a new composition. Click on this new comp icon. We'll call this Brady. We'll make it 1920 by 1080. Choose your frame rate. I'll leave it at 29.97 for this tutorial. Let's make it 5 seconds long. And for the background color, let's make it gray. Hit okay. Okay. And then let's bring in the athlete, the cutout of the athlete. So this one, you can see that it already has a transparent background. So you should, step number one should be cutting out your athlete either in Photoshop. You can also do it here in After Effects or whatever other software you want to cut it out. So that's step number one. And let's go back to our composition. Let's bring in Brady. And if we toggle the transparency grid, you can see that it definitely is on a transparent background. Now let's scale it down, S for scale. And let's drop it down to about 80%. Now go back to your project window and your Brady comp. Let's drag it to the comp icon. And then from here, let's create the border. Let's create the outline. Make sure that your layer is selected in the timeline. And what we'll do is we'll go up to layer, go to auto trace. Make sure that you select current frame. We want alpha channel. And you can leave these values at their default settings and make sure that you apply to new layer. Hit okay. And After Effects creates a silhouette of the athlete. And what we'll do is we'll rename this to border one. And let's move it underneath our athlete. Let's drill down to the mask. And this is simply a solid layer with mask. So the main mask, you can see this yellow. This is our main mask. We can change the color just so you can see that this is the right one. You may have more than one mask. And if I zoom in, you can see there's a mask right here for the helmet, mask 2, 3, and 4. But the one, the main mask that goes around, that's the one that we're interested in. So let's drill down to the mask properties. And what we'll do is we can go ahead and delete the keyframe. We don't need any keyframes. Let's go to the mask expansion and let's expand this mask. Let's make it about 30 pixels. And what we'll do is we can go ahead and add any color. Go to effect, go to generate, and go to fill. And we can sample the color. I think this is a close red or a orange red for the Tampa Bay. Now let's create one more border. So we'll select the border one, Control D, Command D to make a copy. And let's place it underneath. Let's drill down and we'll change this to white. Let's go to the mask properties, go to mask one. And for the expansion, let's try 60. And this is looking pretty good. Now let's give it the hologram look. And what we'll do is we'll fake the reflection by simply moving or sliding that texture across time. And let's go to our project window. We'll be using this texture. I'll have the link in the description so you can use this exact same texture. You can see it's a pretty big image, 5,000 by 5,000 pixels. Let's bring it in. Let's place it at the very top of the layer stack. S for scale, and let's scale it down to about 35%. And you see this little box right here? This little box is a preserve underlying transparency. Let's click on it, and it'll apply it to our cutout. And what we'll do is we'll change the blending mode to darken, and we can go ahead and let's add some levels. Let's go to levels. And let's give it some more contrast. There you go. This is looking pretty cool. And let's hit P for position. And what we'll do is, like I mentioned, we'll animate this over time. Let's bring this in. Let me adjust it through here, through the values. And we can add a keyframe. And then we can go to the very end of the comp. And let's just move it let's adjust the X value. Now, if you want to move it more and it gets cut out, all you need to do is go to Effect. Let's go to Stylize right here. And let's go to Motion Tile. And for the width, you can increase the width to maybe 150 or 200. And let's mirror the edges. And this will simply tile it for you. So we have this nice reflection going on. And now let's go back to the project window. What we'll do is we'll grab the Brady 2 and let's drag it to the comp icon. And from here, we'll add the sticker peel effect. And we'll be using, go to distort, go to CC page turn. We'll be using the CC page turn effect. And we have different options for the control. And you have this little gizmo right here. This controls the peel. You can see the peel. We're peeling it off right now. We can peel it on. And you can control from which corner you want. We have the bottom left corner. We also have the top right corner. Now you have fold radius. You can change the fold radius. Usually I'll leave that between 50 and 100. And you also have a light direction. Usually I'll leave it at minus 60. I don't really adjust these values too much. Now for the render, you can render the front and the back only. You can render the front page only. We'll go and select the front and the back page. And if you want to add a texture for the back side, this is where you can add it, where it says back page. And you would need to bring in that texture into your timeline. And here you would select that layer. But for now, let's hit none. And the back opacity, let's make it 100%. And let's change the color. Let's make it off-white. You can make it black. You can make any color that you want. But let's make it a little off-white. And what you need to do now is simply animate the fold position. So let's go to the fold position. Let's add a keyframe. Make sure that your CTI is at the very beginning. Hit U to reveal or to see that keyframe. And we'll go to 1 second. Let's go to 1 second. And let's move this little gizmo. Let's move it here, okay? And let's go back to the first one and we can zoom out. And if we can see it, here it is. We can just move this. And you can also adjust the values here. Let's check it out. Perfect. So we have that sticker peel on effect. And we can also add a drop shadow. So let's go down to perspective and let's go down to drop shadow. And we'll make the opacity 35, we'll make the distance 20 and the softness 15. Now these are values that you can modify. These are some good, just giving you some good numbers, good values that you can start out with. And one little last thing that you can do is you can add a light sweep. So what we'll do is let's go to Effect, we'll go to Generate, and let's go to CC Light Sweep. And if you can see this little line right here, it's a thin line right now. What we can do is we can increase the intensity so you can see it right there. That's a light sweep. And what we'll do is for the shape, we'll go to smooth. And let's see, the width, we can increase the width. The intensity, we can drop it down, leave it around 50. And you have a couple of different modes. Right now, it's using an add blending mode. You can choose composite and you can choose cutout. And for cutout, that's a different, I use a cutout, but I use it along with other plugins. For now, what we'll do is we'll go to composite and simply animate the center. Make sure that your CTI is at the very beginning. And what we'll do is we'll add a keyframe for the center. We can move this. And let's go to the end of our comp and simply just move this across time. Let's check it out. If you want to increase the width, we can increase the width maybe to about 50. And that is it, amigos. That is how you can create this sticker effect. Very simple. Have fun. Be creative. If you make something, please share. Would love to see your work. And remember that life is truly a gift. Make it count.